wanted to start the show today talking about an aspect or a distinction in communication when it comes to relationships, something that I've talked about before, but wanted to present in a slightly different way. So let me start it like this. There's a difference between saying something that upsets or hurts your partner and saying something to hurt your partner. So there's a difference between saying something that hurts your partner and a difference to something to hurt your partner. So when you talk about that, that means that the intention can be good. When you say something that might hurt your partner, the intention can be good and actually beneficial to the relationship. The second one, when we say something to hurt our partner's feelings, that is with bad intentions and it damages the relationship. Now, this might seem obvious. I don't think anyone thinks it's good to say something to hurt your partner's feelings, although it's very common. It does happen. Sometimes when we get angry, even in a good relationship, you might say something in that moment because you want to hurt them to hurt them. And unfortunately, in some relationships and people's relationship styles that are abusive or toxic or approach relationships in this way, they might intentionally want to harm their partner. And of course, this extends to all types of communication, but specifically, we can put a more of a magnifying glass looking at relationships or romantic relationships where there's more of the intimacy and more need to have this type of healthy communication and avoid the toxic types of communication. But the reason why I bring it up is because although no one would say I should say something to hurt my partner, because we think it's bad to hurt our partner, people avoid saying something that might hurt their partner, although it might actually help the relationship and build a healthier relationship. So because they think I should never hurt my partner, then I shouldn't say something if they won't like it. But that's a very, very bad and unhealthy mindset to have, because if we do that, that means we're going to avoid talking about the important and necessary issues that need to be addressed in order to maintain a relationship. And that word maintain to me is very important, because a lot of times we look at relationships as this static thing. You find the right person, you get into a relationship and you get married, let's say, and that's it. You've made the relationship and it's done, as if it's something that's just now frozen in time. But we have to look at a relationship as a living thing that requires time and attention, and in that sense needs to be maintained and also can be built upon and grown and should be growing during the course of your relationship. So rather than seeing it as something frozen, we need to see the relationship as something living, and anything that's living needs time and attention and love to keep going and to stay strong. So you can imagine two partners and one of them is feeling upset about something. Let's say the partner said or feeling unhappy in the relationship. And they reflect and they think, okay, I'm not feeling good. They get in touch with that feeling. But you know what? I think it's going to make my partner feel sad if I bring it up. So, because I shouldn't say anything that ever hurts my partner, that's being a good partner, is not hurting them, I shouldn't say anything. And this is where the distinction is very important. You have to ask yourself, is my intention to hurt my partner? I just want to insult them or put them down. Or am I thinking of saying something that might hurt my partner, but I think it's actually with good intentions towards helping me feel better, helping them learn about what I'm feeling, and then also, very importantly, helping our relationship to grow together, and also make sure we don't grow apart. Because that is what happens when we avoid talking about these issues. So here it brings up another distinction that you've maybe heard me talk about before. When we talk about pain and discomfort, and I use this a lot actually with parenting, because I think it's very important in how parents approach their kids, but determining or distinguishing between pain that is damage and pain that leads to growth. And the analogy I often use is when we look at working out or exercise. So when you're working out, we say no pain, no gain, and that's very true. In order to get benefits from working out, in order to build muscle and to get healthier, you need to push yourself out of your comfort zone and embrace some level of pain or discomfort. I think Muhammad Ali had some kind of quote like, I only start counting when it starts to hurt, because that's when it counts. So if you don't face some type of pain or discomfort, if you say I'm going to lift weights, but as soon as it hurts a little bit, I'm going to stop, you're never going to build any muscle or really develop anything in your health. So you need to embrace that pain. However, you also have to be aware that there's some pain that's damage. You could be, for example, tearing the muscle. When you're building muscle, there are these microscopic tears that happen. But if you are pushing it too much, you could strain and even pull or tear a muscle in a very unhealthy way that's damaging. Or you can damage ligaments or, you know, your knees, your elbows, things, tendons, ligaments, things like that. That is pain that is damage, not pain that is growth. So we always have to make this distinction also with ourselves, but with our relationships. Is this pain leading to damage or an indication of damage? Or is this pain an indication of growth? Because unfortunately, I've also worked with people, or you see people talk about their relationships, and they sometimes think, well, you know, yeah, it's hurting because this is a good relationship and really intense, passionate relationships, they should hurt. And yes, there's going to be pain and discomfort, and a relationship is going to give you ups and downs, and almost always is going to pull and poke at some of your deepest issues and insecurities. That is going to happen. But a unhealthy, toxic relationship, or one that involves disrespect, violence, aggression, is never a healthy thing, and not at all an indication of healthy or strong love or passionate love. It's a sign that you are bonding with someone over your dysfunction. So the dysfunction is running the show, not the healthy, functional part of what you would hope would be the foundation of your relationship. And the issues are also there, but the foundation is something healthy. So we have to be aware that just because love is hurting doesn't mean it's a healthy or strong love. Some people have experienced only love that involved a lot of pain, whether it was through physical abuse, emotional abuse, constant chaos and arguments and disagreements, that it's hard for them to understand love without pain. So we have to always look at our own foundational relationships with our parents within our home, the marriage that they had together, because that's going to form the foundation of what we tend to think is going to make a healthy relationship, or is going to be what we expect in love, or we don't know if we're feeling love until we feel that pain, unfortunately. So we have to be very aware of that. But coming back to the person who has this feeling that comes up. So if they just think, I should never hurt my partner, then they think or say something my partner doesn't like, then if they are upset or hurt in the relationship, their first reaction is maybe they think something, they think, oh, you know what, I shouldn't bring it up, and they hold it in. And unfortunately, I work with couples who have held things in for too long, and rather than this preventing hurting your partner being good, it's led to a few things. One is, it leads to building up of resentment, because if you don't share those feelings, they don't go away. And oftentimes, if you don't share those feelings, it's about something that's ongoing in the relationship, and the issues just become worse and more ingrained in the relationship, and the resentment is just going to build. And so because of that, and related to that, when you don't share what's going on, you're also going to create more distance between each other. So as I mentioned, the relationship can grow and you can grow together, but sadly, you can also grow apart. And so if I'm not sharing with you what's bothering me, what I'm going to learn to do is avoid you more or get less close to you, or there's going to be a lack of a possibility of closeness if I'm not sharing with you what is making me upset or what's hurting me in the relationship. So in that moment, it might seem like I have a choice of either saying something that might hurt or upset my partner or not. If we look at it just that way, kind of binary black and white, well, then it can seem like, well, of course I shouldn't hurt my partner. And that's why it's important to make that distinction. Am I saying something to hurt my partner intentionally to cause harm? Or am I saying something that might hurt my partner, but can be beneficial and important for me, for my partner, and for our relationship? Even in therapy, I've sometimes worked with couples and let them know, when I'm encouraging you to share these things with your partner, it's not because you want to hurt them or you want them to feel bad. It's actually because you love them so much that you are saying something to them. I love you so much, and I love our relationship so much, that I want to share this with you. So my intention is not to hurt you, to make you feel bad, to damage our relationship. My intention is actually the opposite of all of that. Because I love you, care about you, care about our relationship, and want it to be good and strong, that I'm saying something. So this might seem obvious, but in the moment, we're almost always going to be drawn towards the easier option. We want to say something, but we think it could be awkward or uncomfortable, and so we hold it in. And the same thing is true about the recipient. You're enjoying your day, everything seems okay to you, and now your partner brings up something that's a little bit uncomfortable, might even feel annoying, might be something they're saying you're not doing, so you might even feel insulted or criticized in some way, which doesn't feel good. So the recipient also can have a similar type of reaction, or the other side of that reaction of, why are you hurting me? Why are you attacking me? Why are you making me feel bad? And so we have to be open as the recipient of that, or as members of a partnership, that we're going to have to say, and we want our partner to tell us if we are hurting them. Imagine if you're holding your partner's hand, but you don't know that the part of their hand you're holding onto tight is actually very sore or bruised, so it's hurting them. Now, they could either tell you, you know, the way you're holding my hand hurts because of this part of my hand is bruised, but because they don't want to upset you, maybe they'll think I shouldn't say anything. Would you want them to continue being hurt by you, even if you're doing it unintentionally? Would you want them to continue to be hurt by you, or would you want to be told, even if it's uncomfortable or means you have to change something or means you might have to look at what you're doing and recognize that there is some pain you're causing your partner? I would hope that it's very obvious that although you don't want to hurt them and you don't want to face what's going on, you'd rather know. It's the same thing I deal with parents when at times they don't give space to their child to share their negative feelings. I say, look, if your child had a really bad cold and was in their room, would you want them to hide their cold from you and not tell you and not let you help them? Or would you want them to tell you? So of course you don't want them to be sick, but if they are, you should want to know, and you will want to know. Similarly, in a relationship, if your partner is hurt, you don't want them to be upset or sad or disappointed in you or hurt by something you did, but I would hope that you would want to know if that is the case. And you should also recognize that no matter what, if you're dealing with a relationship of any length of time, you're going to do things that upset them. You're not perfect, and not only it's not even about being perfect, but we have different ways of relating, communicating, things come up, we have bad days, where of course, if I ask you in the last 5 years, do you think you've done something that hurts your partner, and you think no, you're really out of touch with reality and what's actually going on. Of course you've done some things, unintentionally, hopefully, that have hurt your partner. So we should really think, okay, if I've definitely done something my partner doesn't like, I would think I would want to know rather than not know it. So I want my partner to tell me. I want them to let me know if I've hurt them or upset them in some way, rather than to be ignorant of it or think they need to hold it inside. And especially because I've hurt them, I'd want to know, but I definitely want to know to understand it, resolve it, and to make sure I don't keep doing those things. So as the recipient, we will hopefully create the mindset that it might be annoying in the moment, it might not feel as good as hearing something nice or not hearing something at all when it comes to these types of things, but that I want to embrace this and recognize this as part of maintaining, building, creating, and continue to grow a healthy relationship with my partner. Might not feel good in the moment, but like anything that involves growth, sometimes it doesn't feel good to get to that place. And of course, as the person sharing what we're saying, you can't just say, well, my intention is good, I can say it however I want. How we express it, it doesn't mean that now that I'm saying it's okay that it might hurt or upset your partner, you can say it in any way that hurts. You want to minimize the way you hurt them, or you want to be aware not to hurt them more than is necessary. So you want to be genuine and open, but at the same time, be aware that there's kindness in how you share even what you're upset about with your partner. I think sometimes we feel this need that I have to show a threshold has been met that is worthy for me to share it, so we get even more angry. Oh, what you're doing is so bad. Look how bad it is. Because we have to prove it's worth bringing up. But if we actually recognize the threshold is lower that we always want to share, and you don't have to prove that it's so worth it or such a big deal, that makes it a lot easier for you to share it with kindness and love that you're unhappy or upset about something or hurt by something. And even the intention shouldn't be to blame your partner, because sometimes it's something we're sensitive about, something our partner might not be aware of. Hopefully we'll have the mindset that my partner has good intentions, doesn't want to hurt me. And because of that, we can approach it as, okay, my partner did something they didn't realize hurt me, and I want to bring it to their attention. So again, the key distinction is it's good and can be actually very healthy to say something that might hurt your partner, and that's very different from the unhealthy of saying something to hurt your partner. Let's go to our first commercial break. Studio number 310-441-0555. We'll be right back.